No, I think these are all very good. There could have been many more. There could have been, as I said, the UNSC. There could have been also some of the groups like NSG, MTCR, etc., where the US could help us, and we need the help to become members there.
Yeah.
But I go with money. Really, the big ticket item could have been nuclear disarmament, which is should have been very high up on our agenda.
I'm not betting on nuclear disarmament.
It won't happen.
It won't happen, but
yeah. It should happen.
Rather, the discrimination against us should begin to be lifted, and I think that's a good step. But I think looking for the big bang, it's not good.
We're also getting news of endorsement of full membership in four multilateral organizations moving towards.
Yeah.
Can I just interrupt you all? Sarah Jacob traveling with President Obama's media's contingent. Sarah, give us the update. You're hearing a number of things on the removal of restrictions, including, of course, taking DRDO, ISRO and BDL off the entities list. Go ahead with your news.
That's right, Balkha. Mike Forum, the Deputy National Security Advisor for the International Economic Affairs, who's been traveling with President Obama on Air Force One, has now just confirmed this to us all along, Balkha. They've been working on this for a long time, but everybody in the President's team has been saying that they're going to leave all big announcements for when he comes to India. I mean, obviously, they've been aware of the criticism that there is not going to be any big announcements, but now they have confirmed, one, that they're going to endorse India's membership in these four multilateral regions. Of course, this will be in a phased manner, we're told. That was the word he used. He said there's a membership criteria that India will have to, of course, attain. They have to maintain its core system. That was on the first front. Of course, on the 16 entities list that India has, this has been an issue of controversy between India and the US. There's a 200 entities on this list, and they have decided that they're going to go ahead and remove three, that is DRDO, ISRO, and BDO. And they will allow trade and cooperation, this will allow for trade and cooperation in space and defense and high-tech trade. In terms of dual, also they want to announce a lot of business deals between Indian and U.S. companies. But I apologize, I'm whispering right now because the USIBC event is going on and our own Dr. Roy is on stage, but so that's why I don't want to be too loud. But this is some very good news coming in from the U.S. and they're very proud to announce. He said, Mike Forman said that they're going to announce 20 deals between gas, steam, turbine, diesel, locomotive, etc., all these companies. He said they're going to be small companies and big companies, but they're going to announce 20 deals of about $10 billion, and this will lead to 54,000 jobs in the U.S. So this is something the U.S. press, they are very happy to announce this to the U.S. press because they're hoping for some headlines like this abroad to balance out all the negative headlines they've been getting about the midterm elections and the drubbing they're getting there. So I do have some more details. They said that Boeing is likely to get, I'm just flipping through my notes, Parker, a second. They said that Boeing is likely to get some deals, and they're basically working out on a lot of business deals, but they are happy to announce 20 between big and small Indian and the U.S. companies.
Okay, Sarah, thank you. I know you're whispering because you're at the Business Council event. Satish Chandra, I think it's a Wasanar arrangement in the Australia.
Just wanted to make a point. This is excellent news, and I latched onto it when I saw close allies there.
Yeah.
Now, this raises another point, and that is that we have purchased high-tech aircraft from the USA, but we are getting them stripped of the electronics because we are not signing two or three defense agreements which are related to it.
Yeah.
And I don't understand why we don't sign those agreements. I've seen them. And there's nothing terribly wrong with them. They've USA has concluded them with 90 countries. I think this is perhaps a fear that some elements in India will see this as India becoming closer to the USA. So we are getting this high-tech equipment, stripping it off the electronics, putting our own electronics on it, and making a khichdi out of it. Either we don't get those aircraft.
Yeah.
That's fair. But if we are getting those aircraft, why don't we sign the agreements to get them complete?
All right, we've got to end now, Raja. Yeah. Very quickly, what does this mean, these multilateral groups? Is it towards full membership?
We've been kept out of this.
And it's a phased manner.
I think this is a logical extension of the nuclear deal, where India becomes part of the decision-making structures on global non-proliferation. So I think it lifts a big restriction, but it's not going to happen overnight. It's going to be a phased process. But I think the important thing for us, we must begin to move into making rules rather than taking rules. So becoming a rule maker, that is the central issue for us.
So I think that's something. Money you could, yeah.
65% of our population works in the agriculture and allied sectors area. 92% of our workforce is in the unorganized sector. Nothing that is being talked of at this moment in Mumbai has any relationship.
Well, we don't know that there won't be those announcements as well.
There will be. No, in the, please look back at the India-US relationship. In Dwight Eisenhower's time, what was it? It started with agricultural cooperation and technical support. Later on, it went into PL 480 to feed our people. We've had a very strong relationship with the United States in areas that are of concern to the bulk of the people of India. What is talked about now will be of very great interest to those who live in 27-story buildings in Malabar Hill and to those who live in Lutyens' New Delhi. If President Obama wishes to engage with the people of India, okay, the relationship has to be at its strongest in the unorganized enterprise
sector. And those announcements may come as well. 10 seconds, Sanjay Puri, I've got to close. 10 seconds.
I would follow up on Mani's points. There are things like water sanitation, water security, food security. United States can help. India needs that help. Let's go back to the basics that we started with. Create jobs for United States, help India. I think those are the things we should focus on.
Well, Obama's going back with some American jobs, and maybe that will de-escalate the outsourcing controversy at least. But I have to leave it there. Satish Chandra, Rajamohan, Mani Shankar Iyer, Sanjay Puri, Pete Dagger, who's been patiently with us all day. Thanks very much. My colleague Vikram Chandra will be on the other side of the break. President Barack Obama about to speak at the Chambers of Commerce, the Indo-US Business Council in Mumbai.